know, pedophiles, you know, midsections or stuff like that. But if we truly want to help people and we want to stop abduction and we want to stop rape and we want to stop innocent people from being hurt, then we need to have a different approach. And the approach that's being taken now is not really remedying the situation, because it's still very rampant. I mean, I can tell you right now, in Washington, D.C., there's a lot of that stuff going on.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, yeah. And I think a lot of people are awake to that fact.
So I'm more of a person where my father was locked up. I was adopted at 9. My father was locked up. And so it's like someone being born to alcoholic parents. Just because you have genes predisposed to some kind of, you know, diabetes or something like that, doesn't mean I go out there and eat a whole bunch of sugar every day. My concern is about helping people. And people who have called, who said, oh, man, I want to go out there and touch, and I want to go out there, and I tell them no. Well, this post that you put up, say, that has nothing to do with me. You know, that's bait.
Yeah.
All I can say is this, is that there's projects being run by our government, and this is not about advocating anything for anybody to do anything. What this is about is researching and finding ways to stop children and adults, both men and women, from being abused from both ends, because both mothers and fathers have been subjected to and have had their kids taken away in situations that didn't warrant it, and families have been torn apart over this. And so I've been interested in when I was up there in Washington, D.C., meeting with people, talking with people, and realizing that, you know, we need to make sure that people don't get abducted and raped and stuff of that nature. But at the same time, if these things keep occurring over and over and over and over again in society, like a mother breastfeeding, why is it being done? Is it genetic? Because if it is genetic, then we need to approach this completely differently and find out ways to stop people from doing this other than just locking them up.
Well, I agree with that. I agree with that part of it. I'm not sure. I mean, with as much information as we've all found out in the last several years, that it's bigger than an epidemic, in my opinion. I don't know how many people could be affected by this and just have the desire to go out and do this. It really blows my mind. And I was thinking along those lines that I'm suspecting it's genetics, because I don't have those urges or thoughts or feelings or desires at all. I'm one of the ones that I'm repulsed by it. But I can't believe
it really doesn't make sense. But when I've personally have met people who've had those desires, and I know people are cut from different cloths. There are people that will go out there and they'll actually go out there and they'll drive around and they'll snatch somebody off the road, and there's other people who have that. They don't know why they have that. They struggle with it, but they don't talk to anybody about it. They don't know why. You know, they've went through things growing up, but I think it would be healthy to have people discuss these things more often, because I have come to find that that it's just, I can tell you right now, it is rampant.
I think that
if I were to ever really begin a research project, I would be interested in saying, okay, well, I don't think it's right for anyone to just go out there and, you know, put something in somewhere where it doesn't, you know, obviously, you know, fit. I mean, that's not, there's something not going on there that's right. But why are they doing it? What is causing it? What parts of the brain are responsible for those desires? And is it a deformity? Is it genetic? And what can we do instead of just locking these people up, you know, and throwing the key away? Is there other therapies or remedies that we could come up with to help them? Because people suffer with that. And so there are people out there who just say, we're going to go do it, and we don't care what the law is. And there's other people that say, hey, well, there's corruption on government side. It's government's doing it. Then there's the blackmailing. There's the whole government blackmail thing that's going on with politicians.
Right.
And then you have the guys in the very few in the middle that are trying to balance out between the, you know, the criminals on the street and then the criminals in the government. And they're saying, and this, you know, people are saying, well, hey, we've got to really do something about this.
Yeah, I agree. I but then, you know, it's like people that you say struggle with it, like, is it really a struggle for them when they freely go and do that over and over and over again?
Well,
they
no,
really
no, there's an inherent sense of right and wrong in some people. Like, you know, it's like somebody came up and they offered me. I mean, I've seen people, like on the news and stuff, they just go out there and do stuff. But then there's other people who, you know, they have those desires, but they wouldn't want to hurt somebody. You know, you had the whole Michael Jackson scandal thing that went on. Now, whether it was true or not, I don't know. There
right.
was allegations that were made against him. But when you, I don't know. But I know that there are people out there who do those desires, but they're not actively going out and seeking, nor do they intend to. And on top of that, they're trying to understand why. And I think that that might be some of the problem. Because I know the CIA has had a long history of not only just a human experimentation on the psyche, but they've had projects like Project Paperclip, MK Ultra. You know, they've dabbled in drugs and trying to mold and shape our perceptions and, you know, manipulate us with electronics like, you know, microwave frequencies and stuff of that nature. So I delved into a lot of research, and so there are things that I can't even explain because the strings that are being pulled are invisible. So it's kind of
yeah.
like, what's going on here?
It's a fairly large web, and it all comes down to everything's connected, and it's just about people waking up, doing their research, getting their homework together, discussing it openly, and it won't be such a secret and so hard to connect the dots in the future.
Well,
I feel.
And one of the best ways that they do that with their research is I've heard of stories where people will put stuff out there intentionally to get that reaction, and then the information that they pull in is unbelievable. And it's like, well, wait, you can't do that. That's unconventional. That goes against our police department standards. That goes against what we say here at the FBI. And it's like, well, yeah, it's unconventional, right? Yeah, yeah, you're not supposed to put that out there. You're not supposed to say those things. Well, it's unconventional. But guess what? I got all this information that you don't have. And, you know, it's like that's when we were fighting the Revolutionary War. I think that's how we beat the British. We were unconventional. We weren't standing in lines anymore, firing, and then one
right.
line of guys falls down, the next guy, row of guys come up. You know, we were saying, okay, we're going to try to change things up. We're going to start hiding behind bushes, you know, and unconventional warfare tactics. So I'm glad that you called. It's not nice getting those phone calls where you get people saying, you know, do you have rape videos? And, you know,
absolutely.
And would you like to spend time with me and my daughter? There was one up there up north that had a 4-year-old and an 11-year-old. No.
Absolutely.
The only thing that I think should change is we should have some kind of facility that's created and funded by some special research project that takes these people out of society, studies them, and find out if this is genetic. You know, I know breastfeeding, my mother holding a baby, rocking the baby back and forth is a part of a developmental stage. Maybe there's something to do developmentally in the brain that's held back with people that are into that. I don't know.
Maybe it's in your vaccines too. They put everything else bad in those. You know, so.
Oh, yeah, there's
it could
all
be,
sorts
it
of.
Could be some of that
there's
too.
There's also chemical warfare, is what it is.
Absolutely.
It's in the stuff in the food and water supply.
Well, look, a lot of your vaccines, like let's just say the flu shot, for example, that affects your brain. That causes brain swelling. I mean, you won't find any effects in your blood or your urine or your feces if you do any kind of testing like that. But if you study the brain, it's going to show the effects of it on there. I mean, it's, you know, I'm not off the top of my head. I can't, you know, source any sites or anything that I've read or even researched. without looking up my files, but you know, autism, it's huge. So there's things that do affect the brain. So maybe, possibly, it's in that kind of stuff. I mean, we can only speculate. But yeah, I believe that Gitmo is a great place to send people like that. You know, get them out, get them away, and put a research facility inside of there and you know, study them.
Well, because if it's genetic, and we just keep locking these guys up and these people up who, say that people are suffering with that. It's like, you know, I don't want to equate it with Down syndrome, but if people are suffering with that, and it is genetic, and we want to stop these things. I'm just saying from the other end, if they want to stop this, because it's so rampant, instead of just saying, okay, that's bad, we're locking you up, it's against the law, why don't we go and probe further and say, okay, yeah, it's against the law, but let's find out ways that we can really stop it. And if there's a gene that is responsible, like alcoholism or diabetes or arthritis, genes that make it, you know, that make us prone to those kind of diseases, we can isolate that gene. And so when a baby is born, they can be screened. And if they're, oh, there's that little, you know, pedophile gene, or, you know, there's that diabetes gene, you know, then they can remove that gene.
Yeah, but in the same sense, they still need to be away from society. So, yeah, lock them up. If they've done things that are bad and it's been proven that they've done really horrible things, then yeah, they should definitely sit behind bars. All the while, hey, get studied. You know, I'm all for law and justice and being an advocate for people that can't speak up for themselves like a child. So I don't know. I have a different view on that. I don't think that they should be running around free, all the while being tested to see if they can be cured or if it's genetics.
Well, unfortunately, and I'm neutral when it comes to, I try to be neutral when it comes to politics, but unfortunately we've got that Marxist, communist, liberal slide, and so it doesn't end with gay marriage. You know that, right?
Oh, right.
Now,
oh, of course.
Pedophile rights, sodomy,
oh, yeah.
You know, animal love or whatever, you know, it's just going to keep going down until the whole thing just falls apart. It's like the classic Rome scenario.
I agree.
But it goes all the way up to the White House. You know, I just, at the level of corruption and the things that people of power do, and it's like you get a commoner on the street, you know, and you compare the two, and there's two different sets of laws.
That's
there's
true.
There's laws for the poor, and there's laws for the rich. And there's a completely different ball field. And so what do you do when good people like Corey Feldman, who in California, who's trying to expose this, gets death threats, gets you know, he could get blackballed and blackmailed, you know.
Yeah.
You know, you get other people who've tried to expose government projects and programs that actually have information that can really, if disseminated on a, you know, mass scale.
And then they suicide themselves.
People.
Yeah, and then they end up suiciding themselves.
Yeah, it's either suicide or, oh, well, this guy's actually promoting the stuff that he's trying to stop.
Yeah.
See, we got him.
Yep.
We got his, you know, that they do that stuff.
Smoke and mirrors.
I've known a friend that was worked at a gold and silver shop up north, and he was on his computer, and then there's this, he had his laptop open, and the laptop camera took a photo of him and then put it up into almost like a Facebook-like profile, and it said, FBI, warning, if you don't pay such and such, we're going to post all this information out there.
Yeah.
That makes that very frightening world to be in, where your number and your personal information is put out there like that, and then, you know, and then people get this perception of, oh my gosh, this person.
Well, that's what just happened to you.
Well, you just don't know who to trust these days. That's the. I know. I can tell you right now that I do not in any way, shape, form, or anything promote or advocate any laws of the United States being broken. Now, there's laws that I completely disagree with. I am a person who wanted to work for the Central Intelligence Agency, and I put in my unofficial job application. I actually went to the CIA, and I can say that over the phone safely. They don't care about that. That's not a big deal. But I did. I, you know, dropped my information off there and offered some ideas, and I also exposed some stuff that was going on. A lot of it had to do with some religions that were promoting, you know, radical views. And I put my number on that. It was an actual newspaper that I put my number on. And I had it coded. Do you know how the CIA codes everything?
Yeah.
And, you know, and
yep.
The NSA does it too. And I had it coded. But it was so simple that anyone could break the code. And so when I left D.C., I felt like maybe I was being paranoid. I don't know. They don't even have to follow you. They can track your phone, record everything. It's on your phone.
Yeah.
Echelon does that. They can turn your camera on. You know, the police can even dabble in that. Police, oh, my gosh. You know, there's a lot of good ones, but what do you do when the FBI and police and NSA, and you got good ones, you've got bad ones, you've got... It's like, who do you trust these days?
Yep.
You know, that's what scares me, is just like,
you know,
how are we going
to
make any
gut.
Real good change if we can't get people on the same playing field, you know?
Yeah, I agree. Well, Mike, I really appreciate you talking to me. You kind of help ease my mind a little bit, and I'll let everybody else who is in that thread know that, you know, I spoke with you, and you'll probably get, like I said, a large influx of calls. I mean, you just
There's been people, I think, that have, you know, when I was up there in Washington, D.C., like, oh, you're CIA, oh, you're FBI. It's just, there's a lot of paranoia and craziness involved with the internet, and so I'm glad that we cleared that up.
Yeah.
And so I don't know where those websites come from. I don't know if some of them are actual real so-called criminal ones, or if ones are actually like a honeypot. It's created by the government and then stuff's put on there as like a lure. I don't know.
Yeah, we just don't know anymore. I mean, honestly, the only thing that I try to go by is like my initial gut reaction. If it doesn't sit right with me, then I'll, you know, look into it a little bit more. You know, maybe my first reaction wasn't right, but... 9 times out of 10, you should just listen to your gut, because your gut's not going to lie to you. So,
right.
You know, if it resonates, then it must be true, you know? And if you're wrong on something, then, oh, well, you're wrong. No harm, no foul. You learned. So, I really appreciate you taking time out to talk to me. And answering your phone. I mean, I didn't even expect you to answer.
What's that?
I didn't even expect you to answer.
Well, no. I've talked to people who have called my phone, and you know, and they start talking about their, you know, sexual proclivities or what they like, and I sit there and it's almost like a Freud. I didn't really care for Freud's theories, but you know, I kind of just sat there and listened, and it's like hearing them, and more than anything, I mean, yeah, there's a part of me that, you know, who gets repulsed, like, you know, why would you want something like that? I mean, there's some things that just... But anyway, I try to be neutral, and I listen to what they have to say, and then, you know, I'll ask them, well, why is it? Well, how old were you when you started to have these kind of feelings, you know? And I know that most people don't take that approach. Most people say, I'm going to bust your head in.
Oh, right, yeah.
Head in and throw you in jail. And it's like, okay, well, you want to be an advocate to help protect children. Yeah, you can be upset and angry. But if you're really smart about it, then you're gonna really, really want to stop these things from happening. You have to be very, very smart in about the way that you go about it.
I agree.
I listen to them really quick, and so I think, wow, you know, you can find out why these people are doing what they're doing. If you can find out why they're doing it or why they believe they should do it, and then you can start making a dent into and getting deeper into this and being able to find a way to, be able to make a good change in our community, in our environment, but not to get pulled in to the point where you become what you fight.
Right.
Nietzsche was talking about the abyss. You stare long enough into it, it starts to corrupt you, you know, and so you try to be that in that neutral area. But, all right, well, I'm glad that you called, and I'm glad that we cleared that up. I can say I don't know if that one, if those are actually government run, and if it is government run, why don't, you know, if they have posts or whatever, videos, photos, there's all sorts of social media, then that's getting in some gray area, and that's yeah. When our government starts to get in that area where they're putting stuff out there like that, that really is, you know, that's, they're, you know, they're starting to go over to the other side, they're right there in the middle, so.
Yeah, I agree. Well, thank you so much for taking your time and speaking to me. I really appreciate it.
All right.
You have
thank
a great
you.
Day.
Call anytime.
All right. Thank you.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.